Yeah, both the ladies showing off here. And we are ready to go with our eighth fight of the night. And, you know, kind of to piggyback off what Quentin said earlier, one of the most technical fighters we've seen tonight was Rachel Rogers earlier in the show.
Hey, they had no glove touching at the beginning of this.
No, they were out to get each other.
Just coming in straight for the
nice
kill.
Nice teep kick from Clark. Lots of volume.
That was a good body shot.
Ooh, big right hand. And that's one thing that Clark does have is a big right hand. Nice little feint.
Ooh. Clark's dictating the range very well.
Nice right that snapped the head back of Hill.
In the times that we've seen Jessie Clark, she's looked good on the feet. It's just been when she's, you know, gotten taken to the ground that she's had troubles. But right now, she's letting it fly here in this kickboxing match.
Absolutely. Afton Hill's going to have to figure out the range here to be able to be effective in this match.
And sometimes that means putting your feet on the ground. Kicks are good, but if they're opening you up for shots, you might need to rethink what you're doing. She's standing a little square as well. It's easy to be hit when you're not as bladed. But she is receiving instructions from her corner. Nice body kick from Clark.
I like the body language of her, though. She's still aggressive. She's still coming forward. She doesn't look discouraged. So, still definitely in this fight.
Yeah, and she's responding to her corner. They called for a kick. She threw a kick. That's always a good sign from a fighter.
Last 10 seconds, they're banging it out.
Clark's
Let's go. Yes.
Good job there by Clark. And she did a great job of stringing things together too, right? It wasn't just, here's one shot. She was really coming in there with some volume.
Look, Victoria, you know better than anybody. Women don't fight. Women kill. Right? When they're in here, they are trying to kill each other. It's so much harder to be a woman in combat sport. It's not fighting to y'all. It's to the death. And it doesn't matter the level. Like this fight right here, amateur fight, these girls are going at it. That's what I love about watching women fight each other. They're not playing around.
No, they're definitely not. And, you know, part of that is the burden of, you know, not being as, you know, not being as great with it. You know, we kind of got to go out there and show that we can hang.
That's true. So, that's true. But, like, yeah, I own a gym. Some of the hardest roles I have are the girls I got to train with, man. I'm like, y'all chill out a little bit. I got work tomorrow.
Well, there were some very good moments in there for Jessie Clark in that first round, but Afton Hill held her own.
She's very much still in this fight. Ooh.
Oh, that right hand.
That's where you start, you know, it's hard to be a judge in this fight because Afton Hill is kind of pushing forward, being aggressive, but Jessie Clark seems to be landing the better shots.
Definitely. I agree with that. And she does the best when she sets it up with the kick and then comes over the top with that right hand. But she's got to mix it up.
Afton Hill is still pushing. She's pushing that pressure.
But and that's what her coaches are calling for. They are yelling for her to go forward. They seem to think that Clark is tired. She may very well be.
That's right. She's trying to push the pace and wear her down. Michael Braswell in the corner, Afton Hill, longtime Louisiana mixed martial artist. One of the first black belts in Louisiana in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, yeah.
One thing Hill's done.
Oh, that was a good combination from Hill.
Yeah, and she's doing a good job attacking that lead leg as well. It's kind of a, you know, underrated part of this fight.
Hill's playing the marathon. You know, she's running the long game.
Clark firing back, though.
Ooh.
Yeah. She would just be a little bit more patient with that punch.
And
it's open.
She's run into what we had earlier in the night with those reinforced knees. You can't get it with the two hands. You know, it's got to just be one hand there.
It's one hand, one knee, and then you got to go.
Final 20 seconds of round two.
Yeah, I think I had to explain in the ring to, or in the crowd to some people that this is kickboxing.
Yep.
This isn't Muay Thai. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a different rule set.
Yeah, and Adam Rochelle had to learn about that on the fly earlier.
I know, yes. Yeah, it's unfortunate. He still come out with the victory.
He
would have been fortunate to lose in that manner. Yeah, that was a great fight still, you know, even with that.
Yeah, he was very dominant. Did have a couple of deductions there, but came away with the victory nonetheless.
Absolutely.
And we've got a fight on our hands here between Hill and Clark. Really great round right there by Afton Hill, as you guys mentioned, pushing the pace and did a great job kind of attacking that lead leg and landing some shots too.
Yeah, I'd hate to be the judge in that one. That was a tough one to round. I definitely give the first one to Clark. That second round was a toss-up. You know, in the big exchanges, it seemed like Clark was landing the bigger shots, but Afton Hill never stopped. He kept coming after the whole time. So you got to give some credit for that.
Yeah, it does seem like Clark is landing the bombs, but Hill is definitely mixing it up maybe a little bit better, throwing a lot of variety.
Well, and that's something that Clark did really well in that first round. She was going to the body, she was attacking the leg a little bit more. She got a little bit more.
Started headhunting.
Yeah,
with that
started
right
headhunting.
Hand.
Yeah,
but it's when it lands, it's landing so nice. I can't blame her for wanting to go back to that well.
She was very good at keeping Hill at range, and it seems like as she's kind of tiring out, range is, or Hill's starting to get away.
We're training teeps right now. Ooh, nice. So when she lets her hands go and brings them back to her face, she's landing so much better. It's when those hands kind of cycle down that you get...
Right.
You know, you leave yourself so open.
I'm telling you, but this third round, they've been swinging leather for two solid, so I don't blame them for
being a little tired.
Yeah,
their arms are tired for sure.
Ooh, that jab from Clark is just on point.
Yeah.
It's hard to – I feel like she's stealing the rounds just with that jab.
Yeah, it's making Hill hesitant to come in. You can kind of see her. She wants to, but she's thinking a little bit harder about it. There she is, the right hand of her own. We're at clinch.
Hill coming through with some good shots.
A little warning from the ref.
So both fighters have got one warning. Great pace from these two.
This is a war. I'm loving it.
Yeah, I think as far as stringing kicks and punches together, out of hand, the girls have done a much better job of that tonight.
You're right.
I mean, this round has just been constant exchanges. The whole fight, they've just been exchanging the whole time. There's been very little downtime, besides when referee has to stop and tell them to stop clinching. Outside of that, they're just smacking each other.
And we saw that from our first female fight of the night with Rachel Rogers. I mean, she just was constantly, you know, applying pressure and stringing things together.
It's Victoria, why are you girls so mean? I don't get it.
Final 10 seconds.
That was a good jab from Afton. That was a good jab. Let's go. Let's finish strong the last 10 seconds.
What a fight.
Yes.
Nice.
That was an
Afton
awesome
Hill
fight.
And Jesse Clark go the distance in a back and forth war.
That was a battle. That might be fight of the night contention right there.
Oh, for sure.
Certainly. I think we have our highlight of the night, the knockout from Chappelle, but this one definitely in the running for fight of the night to this point.
It's hard to beat a good knockout, but it's also hard to beat a good scrap.
These ladies back and forth, and that third round just as tight as the second. It felt like the only definitive round was Clark in the first. She came out on her horse and did a great job, but these last two have been very competitive.
Kudos to Hill for waking up after that round and said, okay, well, I'm in this, and I'm going to keep the pressure with you. I'm gonna take the hit and keep hitting. And so it made it a very interesting fight.
It just seemed like she couldn't overcome the reach. You know, it was like a lot of her punches had good timing, but she was just an inch or two too short on the exchanges. Like, she had a lot of shots that I felt like if they would have connected, it would have done some damage. It just wasn't right there. But a battle nonetheless. Everybody
won. Some of the crowd on her side.
Right. We're going to have a
loser. They don't call the shots here.
But all the fans are excited. That was fun to watch.
And a great crowd on hand here tonight at Louisiana Downs Casino and Racetrack. I mean, there's not an empty seat in the building, it appears. Really good turnout as kickboxing returns to Louisiana.
This is our first fight of the Downs since the Cage days.
Yeah, this is the first time AKA has actually ever been here at Louisiana Downs. We're excited to be here. And really, really happy to see that this crowd has showed up and showed out all night long. And now Dynamite has the result. Who's going to be your winner? Jesse Clark or Apton Hill?
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of one hell of a fight, we are going to the judges' scorecard. All three judges have seen this bout the same way, therefore declaring your winner by unanimous decision. Fighting in the blue corner, Jesse Clark!
And you can see the emotion on the face there of Jesse Clark. Big win for her, her first win inside the AKA ring slash cage.
Girl, come get your medal.
And she'll now join our Victoria Mason for a little post-fight interview.
I feel like that was a good decision.
It was. It felt like Clark had the, she landed the bigger shot throughout the course of the fight.
Absolutely, yeah. It was a great fight. Afton never stopped, but no, she was just getting the better.
Welcome to the winner's circle. Everyone is so proud of you. We've seen you put in so much hard work these past few months. I know you're excited. How does it feel after such a barn burner of a fight?
It feels great, man. It's been a long time. I've been doing this a while, and it was a much deserved and wanted win. So,
what was going through your mind? You know, you had a game opponent in front of you. You guys are both throwing punches, throwing kicks. It seemed like the action never stopped. What kept you going?
Let's dance, baby. Let's dance. Like, I'm always ready for a banger. It excites me, and I'll fight whoever you put in front of me. So let's go.
There we go. I know you got your husband here with you, your team. Who do you want to give a shout out to?
Well, most of my people are here. I want to shout out to God. Thank you, Jesus. And thank you to my family and all my friends and everybody I got here supporting me. What's up, girl? Brand? And what's up, Center Texas?
All right. Well, congratulations again. You guys give it up for Jesse the Killer Clark.